This is sampling distributions for sample proportions by James Lyon. The example that we will start with says, according to a report by the Humane Society in 2009, 39% of the households in the U.S. have at least one dog, and 33% have at least one cat. Suppose that a random sample of 400 households is taken and the proportion having a dog is calculated. The part A of this problem says, define P. Remember that P stands for the population proportion. Define P in the context of this situation. Now, the way that I would suggest you go about defining P is to first ask yourself, what is the population of interest? And in this case, the population is households in the U.S. And then ask yourself, what is the trait? In this case, the trait is having a dog. Now, you may wonder, well, why having a dog? They mentioned a cat. But when it's in the last sentence, when it says, suppose the sample of 400 households is taken and the proportion having a dog is calculated. So that tells you that the trait they're interested in when they take their sample is the proportion having a dog. So then you can write kind of a generic sentence that says P is the proportion of the population having the trait. That's the generic form. Now in this context, you would say P is the proportion of households in the U.S. that have a dog. Now, that proportion was actually given in the problem in the first sentence, and according to the Humane Society, P is 0.39, 39% written as 0.39. So that's part A. Now, for part B, it says sketch the sampling distribution for P hat. Now, in order to make this sketch, you need to know from your classwork or another video, you need to realize that under appropriate conditions, if you're having random samples, and also checking that NP and N times 1 minus P are at least 10, then this sampling distribution will be a normal curve. So I'll draw a normal curve. And the center of the distribution will be the population proportion. Now, since we have just identified P as being 0.39, and since you know that the P hat sampling distribution is centered at P, I'll put the 0.39 in the center. This is the P hat sampling distribution. Or if you're just saying it casually, you might say it's a pile of P hats from many random samples. Now, the other thing you need to be able to tell from this situation is what the standard deviation is. Now, in general, the standard deviation of the P hat distribution is the square root of P times 1 minus P over N. So in this case, the standard deviation would be the square root of 0.39 times 1 minus 0.39 over the sample size. The sample size in this case is 400. So this comes out to be 0.024. So We'll mark off one standard deviation in each direction. So on the right, it would be 0.39 plus 0.024, which would be 414. Or you might just have rounded that to 0.41 for sketching purposes. And on the other side, about the same distance, would be 0.366. So this is the sketch of the p-hat sampling distribution. Again, you can think of this as if you took many, many random samples of 400 households each, and you found the sample proportion for each one of those samples, and you piled them up on the number line, this is the way they would expect to look. This is the way the pile would look. So that helps us complete this next sentence. 95% of all random samples of 400 households will have between blank percent and blank percent that have a dog. Well, we want to know for all the random samples, remember the sampling distribution is showing us the p-hat for all the possible random samples of 400 households. So we just want to know how far do you have to go to capture the middle 95%. Now, technically, it didn't say the middle 95%, but when you see a question like this in normal distributions, it's almost always what they mean. So 95% in the middle, and that we can go back to the 95% rule, the 69, 95, 99.7 rule. 95% of the distribution is between the mean minus 2 standard deviations and the mean plus 2 standard deviations. So you can say the mean plus or minus 2 standard deviations. So in this case, that would be 0.39 plus or minus 2 times 0.024, which is the standard deviation, and that would be 0.39 plus or minus 0.048, and that would be 0.342 to 0.438. Now, in terms of percent, that would be 34.2% to 43.8%. And if we fill those into the sentence, we can say 95% of all random samples of 400 households will have between 34.2% and 43.8% that have a dog. So that's the end of part C. In part D, it says, if 400 households are randomly selected, what is the probability that more than 180 of them will have a dog? So this 180 is not a proportion, because proportions are always between 0 and 1. And 180 is actual number of households out of 400. So we need to think of that in terms of a proportion, and put it on our sketch of sample proportions. So first of all, I'll make a repeat of the sketch of sample proportions again. So it'll be the normal curve. And the center is at 0.39. And the standard deviation is 0.024 from above. And so we need to find out what is the probability. Now, when you think of probability, if you think of this again as a pile of p-hats, all the possible sample proportions piled up here, we want to know probability is asking what percentage of those p-hats are going to fall higher than the p-hat that goes with 180. So we have to, first of all, maybe figure out what the p-hat is at 180. 180 divided by 400, and that comes out to be 0.45. So we want to know how many of the proportions are higher than 0.45. So I'll put 0.45 out here to the right, and we'll see about if this is about right. And I'm going to shade in that little tiny tail area out to the right of 0.45. Now I know it's pretty far out because 0.414 was one standard deviation, as you saw in part B. So this is pretty far out in the curve and has just a small tiny tail area beyond it. And that tail area corresponds to the probability. Now in order to figure out that probability, we need to go through the usual work when we have to work with a normal distribution. You need to find the z-score. And the z-score, as always, is the value, which in this case is 0.45, minus the mean, which in this case is 0.39, and divided by the standard deviation, which is 0.024. And that comes out to be 2.5. So this sample proportion of 0.45 would be 2.5 standard deviations above the mean at 0.39. Now, to get the probability, we can use the normal CDF on the calculator. And so we'd say normal CDF from 2.5 to some very, very large number. You can take your favorite, kind of like infinity, because it looks a little bit like, kind of like 100, because it looks a little bit like infinity. At any rate, 2.5 to 100, when you do that on your calculator, 0.0062. I'll just round it off to 0.006. So the probability then, 0.006, that's a very small probability. That's 6 thousandths, which is 6 out of 1,000. And again, that's imagine having 1,000 beads and 6 of them are red, and you reach in and pick one bead and you get the red one, or a red one. So that's a very unusual thing to happen. So we can write our answer in the sentence form. The probability is 0.006 that a random sample of 400 households will have more than 180 having a dog. It would be a very unusual thing to happen. And that's the end of this example. Hope it helps.